Hi, in this video I will show you how to create a flow to convert office files to PDF without using any premium subscriptions or third-party connectors. For this, we have two scenarios. The first one is converting single file to PDF, which I will explain it in this video, and the second one is converting multiple files to PDF, which I will explain it in the next video. So now let's see what is this flow required to be created. For any flows to run, we need to have a trigger. Here I want to run the flow when the file is created inside the folder on SharePoint. So I have to have the trigger called when a file is created. For this scenario, I have created a folder called Power Automate inside a folder ICT, which is belong the documents library. So whenever a file has been created inside this Power Automate folder or a file uploaded to it, this trigger will run. The next step is to get the content of the file which has been uploaded or created inside this folder. Then we create a copy of this file which has been uploaded to this folder inside our personal OneDrive. So for this reason, I have created a temp folder inside my desktop. This is my OneDrive. Then we convert this file which has been copied to this folder to a PDF using this action convert file to PDF. Then we have to create a copy of this file, of this PDF file, on the SharePoint. So we have to have another action to create a copy of this PDF file on our SharePoint. And for this, I have created another folder, Power Automate slash PDF under ICT folder, in order to make a copy of this PDF inside this folder. For this, we need another action, create file. So this action will be used to create a PDF file from this action, convert file to PDF. So let's see in action how we do this flow. This is my Power Automate homepage. To create a flow, click on create and then click on automated cloud flow. Then give a name to our flow and then write when a file is created in order to filter the triggers. Then select when a file is created, then click create. Our flow is created and our trigger is ready to be customized. So we choose the site address and document library. Then we have to specify that folder name which we upload or create the file inside it. For this demonstration, I have created Power Automate folder inside ICT folder. So I will select that folder from the shared document, then the ICT folder, then the Power Automate folder. So anytime we create or upload file to this folder, this trigger will be run. The next step is to get the content of this file which has been uploaded or created. So I will choose get file content and then I will choose the same site address. Then I have to choose the file identifier. For this, we write the identifier to get it from the trigger when a file is created. So write identifier, click identifier. This way we get the content of the file which has been uploaded or created inside the folder Power Automate. The next step is to make a copy of that file which has been uploaded to the SharePoint folder to my personal OneDrive. To do so, let's add a new step and then create file. Click on create file and then choose the folder which is on your personal OneDrive. In my case, on my desktop, I have temp folder. For the file name, I'm using the dynamic content and the file name will come from the trigger when file is created. And I will choose the file name with the extension. So I'll write file name, then I will click on the file name with extension. This will come from the trigger when file is created. But for the content, I will get it from the get file content action. So click on the file content. This way we can get a copy of this file and make it available on our personal OneDrive. Then we convert this file to PDF, write convert to, and choose convert file. And then the file is the one which we created on our personal OneDrive. We can find it by using this ID. So I click ID and then click next. This time we create a copy of that PDF on SharePoint folder. For this, I have created a different folder, a separate folder under ICT folder, and then choose create file action. Choose the same site address and the folder path is the folder which I have created under ICT folder, which is called Power Automate slash PDF. And then the file name, we get the file name from the converted file. So click file name and the content will come from the same place, from the same action, convert file. This way we were finished creating our flow. Click save and then click test to see if the flow is working as expected. Click test and then manually click test again. Now the flow is waiting for us to upload the file. So I'll go to my SharePoint folder and click file, upload the file, new laptop, open. Once the file has been uploaded successfully, the flow will start running. As you see on my personal OneDrive, I have a folder, temp folder, the file has been copied to. And on the SharePoint folder, the PDF folder is empty now because the flow is not finished yet running. So we are waiting to be successfully finished. Then if I click refresh, I will see the PDF version of my Excel file will be created inside this folder. Now everything is working as expected, but we have one thing. Each time we create a file or upload a file to the SharePoint folder, a copy will be created inside this temp folder on my personal OneDrive, which may take a storage from my OneDrive. So it is good practice to delete it after it converted to PDF. So I'll go back to my Power Automate and then click Edit, and I will add another action, delete. So write delete in the search and then click delete file. So the file which we want to delete, it should be from the create file action. So we get it by the ID from the create file action. So scroll down until you get to create file action and then select ID. This way we were able to delete that file which has been created on my personal OneDrive after it converted to PDF. So let's test the flow again to see the file will be deleted after creating the PDF file or not. So it is waiting for us to upload the file to my SharePoint folder. So I will upload another file, click files. This time I will choose another Excel file. The file has been uploaded. Then as you see, the flow start running. Now if I check my temp folder on my personal OneDrive, the file will not appear here after it converted because it will be immediately deleted after it converted to PDF. So let's refresh it to see if it is there or not. It is not there. If I check my SharePoint folder and click refresh, the file has been created. But if I go back to my personal OneDrive, the file is not there because it has been deleted immediately after the file converted to PDF. I hope this video was useful for everybody. In the next video, we will talk about how to convert multiple files to PDF using Power Automate.